bless the name of the Lord. And my one brother said, tell it to Jesus. Tell him all about it, for he'll understand it. And it doesn't matter what I'm going through. Prayer. My 15 minutes is up. But if you understand that prayer works, I want to tell you, don't give up on it. Daniel did not give up on prayer. But the Bible says that he threw the windows open and he called upon Jehovah God. And he prayed unto God. And he lifted up his soul unto God. And he poured out his heart unto God.
And some fast people hear him. Spying on him, Bishop. They were spying on him. And as they spied on him, they got the evidence. Prayer is evidence, you know. It is tangible evidence. You can't deny it. So when they call up Daniel, Daniel can't deny the thing because he knew it. Because the window was open. And there were many witnesses. There were many witnesses. How many have heard us testify in church? Oh, I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I can see. And when trouble comes, they can't find you in the house of God. When trouble comes, where is the testimony? Let me know that. Let me tell you something, that the testimonies that you have gone forth will stand as a witness against you. Oh, bless the name of the Lord, because out of your mouth you have declared a thing. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. And so Daniel could not deny, yes, I prayed, and the decree has been made, but I can't give up on this. I can't give up on God. I can't give up on what I know. I can't give up on what I've tried. I can't give up on what I've tested and what I've found to be true. So, oh, King Nebuchadnezzar, I am guilty as charged. Yes, I prayed, but for God I live, and for God I die. I might lose my job, but I stand for God. For God is my provider. The writer said he's got the whole world in his hand. Nebuchadnezzar, he got you in his hand. And had it not be for him, you would not have been where you are. So my God is not predicated on what your belief system is. It's not predicated on every victory that I win. It is not predicated on any battle that I've seemed to lose. He is God all by him. Prayer works. So the decree has been passed. Sometimes the enemy comes and he intimidates us with his lies. He intimidates us with impersonality. And intimidates us with the trends and with money. And sometimes we fall to it. And threats. And threats. Him threatening we know we dream. Him threatening when we walk on the road. He's threatened us in our jobs. He's a roaring lion. The Bible says, Shekinah, whom he may devour. And so the king has passed the decree that he himself cannot change. Say it, somebody. As my grandmother would say, I'm wicked and bad. How is it that, Bishop, if you give me certain authority now, if you give me the authority, I am not going to put in a decree that even I can't change it.
Makes sense.
I am not disqualifying myself out of the job. So if it has to be reconsidered, then I must have, whether it's myself or a team of people, some authority for accountability. Set up that in case there is something that come up that is of the norm, an anomaly or something, that the decree can be changed. But this king was so caught up on himself that he didn't think, hold on a second, I'm putting myself in jeopardy. Well, I was the one that signed the decree and I can't change it.
Oh, but he went to Daniel. He said, Daniel, I wish. That's what he, in essence, what he was saying. I wish you would just recount and just because I don't want to put you. I don't want to put you in the lion's den. But Daniel, I like you because I found favor in you. And Daniel, I want to exhort you and I want to lift you up. And many of us might have been of the mindset that we would have said, okay, King, just for more favor, I'm gonna give it up. I'm gonna curve the time that I pray. I'm gonna do it behind windows or closed. Daniel was thrown in the lion's den. And as he was thrown in the lion's den, the king wrestled all night. Oh, bless God. God is going to fight our battles for us. The writer said, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. God wants to fight our battle. The Bible says that they put him in the den, and we know how the story goes, and that they sealed it with the king's own signet. Oh my God, that it could not be changed. And the king went to his palace and passed the night. The king couldn't eat. His appetite was removed from him. Neither were the instruments that would normally bring him pleasure were brought before him. The Bible says that he could not sleep. Tell somebody, when you're in the cross of trouble, just find yourself in a corner, anchor yourself, and call upon God, because while you are there, you don't gotta fight your battle, because God is shedding somebody. Somebody's losing sleep, somebody's losing their appetite. And the king rose early the next morning and made haste. He didn't take his time, he didn't stop to have breakfast. That he made haste, and he went early in the morning, and when he came unto the den, he cried with lamentation, he cried unto Daniel, he cried out with a loud voice, and he cried, oh Daniel, listen to this, in the midst of prayer, watch the king testify, oh servant, insurance that we have on prayer. In Matthew, it declares that, and if you seek, you shall find.
But when he left, he sent us a comforter. And when I know not what to pray, when I know not how to pray, the Bible says that he maketh groanings that cannot be uttered. So I don't have to have excellency of speech. I don't have to have a decree. I don't have to have a certificate on how to pray. I just go down on my knees and I call upon him and he teaches me how to pray. He, the disciple, said, Lord, what should we pray? And he said, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Give praise and honor unto God. And so the decree is made. An outline is given on how we ought to seek the Father.
Sister, but it's me, God.
against me and all my issues, me and all my pain. But I'm running to the master's head. I'm coming to him when doctors fail.
That is it.
Make your supplication known. with a conquering prayer.